Lloyd, Marika, we have a little problem here. Little problem, right? That we'd like you to help us figure out and solve, okay? They're gonna help us. Now, what do you think would happen if you push this box right here? If you push it this way, what
will... It'll make all of them knock over.
You think it'd make all of them knock over? He thinks they'll all fall down. Okay, I think you might be right. Now, tell me though, first, before they all fall down, what's going to happen when this box, when you push this box over, what's going to happen next?
It would hit this box.
You think this box will hit this box? And then what will happen to this box?
It would hit that box.
Ah, this box is going to hit this box, right? Then what'll happen?
And this box will hit that box.
You think so? You think this box is going to hit this box? Okay, then what's going to happen to this box?
This box, that box is going to hit that box.
This one?
Yeah.
Well, then what's going to happen to that box?
It's going to hit that box.
This is going to hit that one? You sure of that? Yeah. So you think this is going to hit this one, this is going to hit this one, this will hit this one, this will hit this one, and this will hit this one, and they'll all fall down like you said in the first place, right? Well, let's see if you're right. You want to try it? You are right. That's what happened. Okay, now Linda said you did very well on the first problem. Now, we have a little bit harder problem to figure out. What would happen if... Okay, first this is the trough, right? And then I'm going to put this brick down right about there. Looks like a good place. And then I'm going to take this plastic box, and I'm going to put that right, looks good about there. Okay? Now we have a trough and a brick and a box.
Okay.
Now, what will happen if, Marika, you put that ball in the trough? What do you think is going to happen? If you just put that ball in the trough there, what do you think might happen? What's going to happen to the ball, first of all?
It's going to go down the trough. It's going to go down the trough.
It's going to go down the trough, you think, right. Then what do you think will happen?
It'll touch the brick.
It'll touch the brick somewhere? Okay.
Yeah.
Then what do you think might happen? Then what?
The ball will go into the box.
She thinks the ball will go into the box. Do you agree with that, Lloyd? You think that's what's going to happen if Marika puts that ball?
It will roll down and hit the brick and go into the box.
Sounds good to me. Let's try it. Marika, you want to try it? Okay, there goes the ball. Hey! What do you know? Terrific! It worked just like you said. Now, Linda said the last problem was hard, but this problem is the hardest. Got your thinking caps on? Okay, let's set this problem up. Now, first of all, you can see what... This is a stick, piece of wood, right? It's kind of like a little seesaw, isn't it? Over a thing here. Now I'm going to put this brick about right there. Then I'm going to put this piece of wood on top of the brick. And then I'm going to put the ball on top of that little piece of wood. Now, what would you think will happen if you very carefully push that stick down?
It would hit it, and the ball would fall into there.
Well, now tell me, first of all, what's going to happen if this goes down? What's going to happen to this board before anything else happens?
It would come up.
What do you think, Marika?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
This board is going to come up. So if this board comes up, what's going to happen next?
It's going to tip this part.
It would hit this.
Wait, before it tips this, it has to do something down here, right?
It would hit this, and the ball would fall to here, and then fall into here.
That sound right?
Yeah.
This is going to come up. You think it's going to hit this and, what, push this up higher?
Yeah, and then the ball will fall over to here, and then fall into here.
Do you think it'll work? You think it's just crazy enough that it might work?
Yeah.
You want to try it?
Right.
Okay. Go ahead. Hey! Congratulations. Very good. Very good.
Huh, you think that was a hard problem? I have a hard problem much harder than that one.
What problem do you have, Big Bird?
Well, I was watching you, and I think I came up with a much harder one here. See this little thing I've piled up here? First of all, you have the two cigar boxes, one on each side,
mm-hmm.
and then there's a graham cracker box,
mm-hmm.
and then there's a dish,
mm-hmm.
and then there's a cup balance, and on top of that, a flower pot with some watercress going in it.
Wow.
So, the question is, and here's the hard part, what do you think will happen if someone was to take out this cigar box and took it carefully out? What do you think will happen to the things piled up on top?
There were four.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, Lloyd, this is your turn. I want you to carefully to slide that box out, and we see what happens. Ta-da!
Hey, what's going on here?
See, I glued them together. That's why it was a hard part.
Oh.
I fooled you.
Wapoos is rabbit in Cree.
Oh, really? Wapoos?
Wapoos?
Mm-hmm.
Wapoos.
Wapoos? This is a rabbit?
No, that is not a rabbit.
I didn't think so. But it doesn't look like a rabbit.
He's not a rabbit, but he has a habit of changing his name.
Oh, is that one of the names he calls himself?
I call him, I say, Cody, he won't come unless I say, hey, Wapoos.
You're a Wapoos?
And you know what?
Plums.
That's another one.
I asked him a little while ago what his name was, and he said Plums.
Well, the first thing he did, he changed his name to Toothpaste. I'll sing you a song about it. Here, Wapoos, you sit over here. Okay, you sit right there. Okay, and we'll tell you about it, huh? We'll sing Bob all about it. I got a little boy. Used to be his name was Cody. Cody, Cody, Cody. It was Cody all the time. It was Cody here and Cody there. Cody, Cody everywhere. I got a little boy. It used to be his name was Cody. Then he changed his name to Toothpaste. It was Toothpaste all the time. It was Toothpaste here and Toothpaste there. And Toothpaste, Toothpaste everywhere. Well, I got a little boy. It used to be his name was Cody. Then he changed his name to Toothpaste. And then he changed his name to Plums, and it was Plums here and Plums there, Plums, Plums, every old arrow. I got a little boy, used to be his name was Cody, Cody Toothpaste Plums, and now it's Wapoos all the time. I say, what's your mama's name? Wapoos. What's your daddy's name? Hey, what's your daddy's name? You raisins? What's your kitty's name? Wapoos. What's your doggy's name?
What's your doggy's name?
Uncle Augie.
What?
Uncle Augie.
Uncle Augie?
Uncle Augie.
I think he's done it again.
Just...
What's your auntie's name?
What's your auntie's name?
Donut.
Donut?
Donut?
What's your name?
Frisbee.
Frisbee? What's your daddy's name?
Frisbee.
Frisbee?
What's your mommy's name?
Baby.
Oh!
What's Bob's name?
What's my name?
Frisbee.
And what's Maria's name?
Wapoos.
Wapoos.
Well, it looks like everybody.
What's Mr. Hooper's name?
Wapoos.
Wapoos.
Period. There. Oh, hello. Ah, I see you've caught me here in my little study, where I have just written two real neat poems. Would you like to hear them? Well, they're all about short time and long time. Now, the first poem here is about a short time. It goes like this. Short time poem by me, Big Bird. My short time poem has just begun, but it takes such a short time, it's already done. There, see? It didn't take long because it was supposed to be a short time. Now, I have a long time poem for you. Let me just add a word or two there. Now, here is my long time poem. My long time poem has just begun, but it takes such a long time, it goes on and on, and on and on, and on and on and on, and on 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 and on. And on 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 and on. I told you it was a long time poem. And on 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 and on. And on 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 and on.
head
See?
Off.
You say bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you later,
bye-bye.
Cody.
Bye-bye.
Bye. It's bye. Really cute, isn't it?
Yeah, but I don't understand what Buffy just said. She said that she had to get Cody ready for daycare. What's that?
Oh, daycare. That's where she takes Cody when she can't stay home and take care of him sometime. See, Sheldon's busy today, and Buffy has a rehearsal for a concert. So neither one of them are going to be home, so they're going to take Cody to daycare.
But what is a daycare?
Well,
you want to leave him there by himself?
Well, no, not by himself. Well, let me tell you what daycare is. See, it's a place where a lot of little children get together to be with each other, and where some grown-ups come and take care of them all at the same time.
Well, what if they don't know him? I mean, they won't even know his name.
Well, if they don't know his name, Buffy will tell him what his name is, or Cody can tell himself. He talks now. And they'll play with him. They'll have a great time there.
But he's going to be there all day. What if he gets hungry?
If he gets hungry, Big Bird, he'll eat. They have plenty of food there. It's no problem.
Well, what if he had to go to the bathroom? He's too little to go by himself.
If he needs help to go to the bathroom, that's what the grown-ups are there for, to help him.
What about his toy car? Could he take his toys?
Sure, he can take his toys.
Well, what if he lost it?
Well, that's not likely to happen because, you see, they all have their special little places for all their own little things, and so they know where things are all the time, so it's not likely that he'd lose anything.
But if he cries, well, who'll pick him up?
That's what the grown-ups are there for. They'll pick him up and take care of him, Big Bird. They're terrific at taking care of little kids.
Well, then, how will he get home?
When Buffy finishes her rehearsal for her concert, she'll go to the daycare center and pick him up and bring him back home.
Oh. Well, what do they do at the daycare center?
Oh, lots of things. They learn things and have fun. They play games and talk and sing songs, read stories. If they get tired, they can take little naps and things. You know, all the things that kids love to do.
Well, it sounds good.
It's terrific. You have nothing to worry about, really.
Oh, good.
Yep. Oh, let me give you a hand with that. Oh, yeah.
Woo.
You got you. Oh, that's heavy.
Yep. Woo. I'm ready to go. Goodness.
You all ready to go, Cody? You're going to a daycare center. And you're going to have lots of fun. Why, you know that they do all kinds of things. And if you're getting hungry, don't worry. They'll take care of you. And you can bring your toys with you. And don't worry, they'll take care of you. And you don't have to be afraid of anything. If you cry or anything, they'll pick you up. And you play. There's lots of other kids. They'll meet you. And they'll know your name because your mommy will tell them. And you'll have so much fun.
You know what? You know what's so much fun about a daycare center? There's always so many kids to play with, right?
Right,
we can
yeah.
play a really good
like
game.
David,
why don't we play a game with all the different parts of our body? Let's start with our head. What can we do with our head?
I eat
pat your head. That's good. Pat your head.
Pat your head.
Pat your head, Rhett. Okay, what else? What else can you do? What's next? Down on your face.
Okay.
What's next?
Pull your teeth.
Pull your teeth. Oh boy. Mine look like somebody pulled them already. That's what my grandfather used to do. He used to go.
Hey,
how about blinking your eyes?
Well, yeah, blink
no,
your
no.
eyes.
No,
no.
How about,
you can't talk, your mouth is zipped up.
No, I unzip it.
You unzip it? Oh, okay.
What are we gonna do? How about make grouch faces?
Making grouch faces?
The whole face?
Wow.
Oscar would love this game, wouldn't he?
Grouch face, too. Look at this one.
Oh, that's a grouchy face, all right. You look like your face hurts when you do that.
Can okay. you wiggle your nose?
Wiggle your nose.
Oh, that's a grouchy face, Brett. Who can wiggle your nose? You wiggling your nose?
That's not your nose.
Wiggle your nose. We look like little bunny rabbits.
Mommy, I have wiggle my nose.
Oh, that's good. What else? What else?
Rashida, what can you do? What can you do?
Stomp your feet.
Stomp your feet.
Okay. Okay, what else?
It hurts my feet.
That hurts your feet?
Don't do it too hard.
What else?
Snap your fingers.
Snap your fingers.
Yeah,
all
that's right. a good one.
Deep, 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 deep. What else?
Right.
I like that.
Twiddle
like
your
that
thumbs.
One. Twiddle your
Twiddle
thumb.
Put your hands together like that. Look like this.
First, huh?
See? And then go like this.
And then we twiddle.
Good.
Everybody can do it.
What? Make like a bird and flap your arms.
Wow.
Fly.
That was good.
Fly,
whoop, whoop, whoop. This little bird down here by me is flying away. Look at that. Where are you going, Andrew? Andrew's taking off a mile a minute there.
What do you got there?
Oh, thanks, Linda.
What's that? Did you have a good time at daycare?
I think he did. He sure looked like he was having fun.
Oh, that's good. Hey, take a look at this. Look.
What is that?
I don't know.
Big Bird's Daycare Center. Where'd that come from?
I wonder what that bird is up to now. Let's
Once upon a time, there was a mama bird, a papa bird, and a little baby bird. Well, they all lived together in a big nest. Shh, egg bird. You be quiet and listen. They all lived together in a big nest deep in the woods. Oh, hi, everybody.
Hi, Big Bird.
Say, what do you think of my daycare center? It sounded like such a good idea, I thought I'd start one for all my little egg friends here.
Oh, it looks terrific.
We're having a wonderful time. We played with the toys and sang songs, and now I'm reading them a little story before their nap time. Mm. Yeah, well, if you excuse me, I better finish the story before they fall asleep.
Okay, Big Bird.
Okay, bye-bye. Now, where was I?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters Y and Z, and by the number 4. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.